Yeah, today we're going to make a spicy pasta and we're going to top it with feta cheese. This is your ingredients, this is what you need. Some linguine, which is like a flatter sort of spaghetti, but you can use the other pastas with it if you want. Some chilli flakes, some olive oil, two tins of chopped tomatoes. You're only going to use 1.5 of these tins, of the 400 gram tins. Some ground black pepper. This is 25 gram of basil. This is fresh basil, and there's an aubergine, quite a good size one, and some Greek feta cheese, and 3 garlic cloves. So we're just going to prepare these, and then we'll get back to you. Okay? The first thing you're going to do is you're going to cut your aubergine up. You're going to fry this in olive oil. So you want to cut them into slices, and you'll wash it first, obviously, and then you want them in 5mm slices. So you want them like that. So when you've cut them all like that, we'll get back to you, okay? Right, sliced up our aubergine. Now we're going to fry them in olive oil. So we're going to put a layer of olive oil in, like so. This is quite a quick dish to make, and it's very good. My daughter likes it very much, and she's only 6 now. Sunday she was, wasn't she?
She was.
Right, we're going to put your slices of aubergine now in your olive oil. You might have to do this in 2 rounds to get them all done. Okay. Turn it on to like just over a low heat, so you want it sort of going on to medium. And you're going to fry them off until they come like a goldeny brown. So we'll get back to you when we've done that. We'll show you how they're supposed to be when they come out. Okay. Right, when you're frying them, you're going to fry one side till it's golden. And then you're going to turn it over and do the other side till it's golden, and then we'll get them out. So we'll come back to you when we've got them nice and golden, okay? Yeah, when we're cooking, and we've turned them a couple of times, just to get them evenly cooked. And that takes you about maybe 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, so when they're done completely, we'll come back to you, okay? They're about ready to take out now, so they've gone like a golden colour. If you get them with the tweezers, would you say they are, whatever? Grabbers.
Yeah.
If you get them with these and shake them, you get more of the oil off than doing it with a spoon. So get them with those and put them on there. So we've got now 2 sheets of kitchen roll under here. We're going to put a layer of these on, and then we're going to put another 2 sheets of kitchen roll on top, and then do your next batch. Okay? So we'll get back to you then. I've worked out what they're called now, and they are called tongs.
They are tongs, yeah. Definitely.
Okay, for future reference. Okay? Aubergines fried. And we're just going to put another 2 rolls of kitchen towel over the top and press it down. I'm going to set that aside for a minute. Now what we're going to do is get pans empty. Now we've transferred the fat to another pan, so you can use it again for scrambled eggs or whatever, omelettes and stuff like that, whatever. Right, now we're just going to use a dessert spoon of olive oil. Just put that in there. Only a small dessert spoon, don't put a lot in. And then what you're going to do, crush your garlic, your 3 cloves, and put it into the oil, and then we're going to fry it lightly. So I'll just get them crushed in ready, and then I'll come back to you, okay? We've crushed the garlic, your 3 garlic cloves. We're just going to turn this on to quite a lowish heat, and we're going to sort of stir fry this for about a minute, just till it goes slightly golden. So we'll come back to you in that minute, okay? We've added on about 2 or 3 minutes, and now it's gone like a golden colour. Slightly golden, that's how you want it. We've just turned it up a minute. Then we're going to get a chilli flakes. And you don't want to put a lot of chilli in. You want to put maybe 1/4 to 1/3 of a spoon. I wouldn't go any more than that, because you don't want it quite strong, because the chilli flakes really flavour it up. Unless you're really tolerant to spices. Okay, so we're going to do that. And then you're going to put in 1.5 tins of your chopped tomatoes. I'll just get the spoon from that. Spoon it in. Do it that way and then you can see more what's going on. Make it a good half. Right. Now what we're going to do is then put this on like a simmer for about 10 minutes. We're going to add some ground black pepper now as well. Just add a good few turns. and then let it simmer for about 10 minutes or so till it goes thicker. I'll show you what it's like in 10 minutes. Okay. Cooking, you might as well get your basil open and take your leaves off and start preparing it. Just give it a wash. So we're just going to get the leaves off and chop them up. Okay, so we're ready with that. Right, we've had it going for about 10 minutes, and as you can see, it's gone thicker. You see the texture of that, so it doesn't run immediately away when you put the spoon onto it. What we're going to do is just turn it off for a minute, and that basil that we've chopped up, we're just going to put that in. It's quite roughly chopped basil. And then with your aubergine, just press it down again, just to make sure you've got most of the oil off. And then what we're going to do, I'm going to get our scissors, because we like our scissors in cooking, don't we? And we're going to just cut it up and put it in. And when we've cut it up and put it in, we'll get back to you. Okay? To pull her over it, aubergine, we're just going to stir it all in now and just cook it for a couple of minutes till the basil has gone down, if you will. It's broken down. And then we've got a linguine on. So this is only a couple of minutes just to warm it up pretty much now. We'll get back to you in a couple of minutes. Okay? As you can see now, the basil has cooked in, and so has the aubergine and that. Now that is pretty much ready. Now a linguine is ready as well. And what we've done, we've got some Greek feta and we've sliced it probably about a centimetre by a centimetre and a half or half an inch, depending on what you're doing it in. And just put the squares on top of it when it's done. So we're just going to cut that up and then we'll show you it's served. Okay. We've served it on a bed of linguine with the pasta sauce on top, and then just cut a feta on top. And that's basically it, really.